All right, glasses on, it's time to be serious. If you're a VJ, I think this information will be useful. I have my Resolume composition open. This contains a bunch of video clips I'm going to be using at a party called Wave Blades this Saturday in Warsaw, and there's going to be several artists and DJs performing, all of whom I have no idea what BPM or tempo they're going to be playing, so I'm just going to tempo tap in Resolume while listening to their music, and because I have every clip set to BPM sync, all the clip playbacks will adjust accordingly, speeding up or slowing down depending on how I set the BPM. Most of my Resolume effects parameter modulations are also synchronized to the BPM, and this ensures that everything happening visually matches the timing and the energy of the music. But the thing I really want to explain in this video is how I made all these clips beat syncable in the first place. Let's take a look at the 3D logo animation here in Blender. First thing to notice is the first and last frames are the same. This means that the animation, when rendered, will play as a loop. What's the frame rate of this animation? I've set it to 30, which is the same frame rate as my Resolume composition. But the less intuitive part to understand is, why is this animation set to 1,152 frames? What's so special about this number? Well, I came to the conclusion several months ago that all my rendered animations should have a standard frame rate and a standard visual BPM, so to speak. This would ensure that every oscillation, visual cue, and keyframe lands on a beat in a predictable way that doesn't leave any room for falling out of sync with the music or missing any cues. I decided all my animations should have a visual BPM of 100 because the math is very easy. When a DJ is playing at, say, 140 BPM, then the clip just needs to play back at 140% its original speed. Because we live in a world where songs have structure, it only makes sense that my VJ clips should also have some sort of structure and have a duration of something like 16 measures or 16 beats. So then, given a standard frame rate of 30 FPS and a consistent visual BPM of 100, how many frames is one beat or one measure? Well, if we do some dimensional analysis, 60 seconds per 100 beats times 30 frames per 1 second gives us 18 frames. If we want the visual clip to be 64 beats long, then that would give us 1,152 frames. See where that number came from now? Of course, you can multiply or divide this magic number by any multiple of 2 for longer or shorter clips. This also means that I don't have to guess where significant keyframes should go. They will nearly all of the time be frame number 72, 144, 288, 576. You get the point here. For oscillating motion in Blender, you will find this equation very useful. 2π is one full cycle in Blender, 30 is the desired FPS, and 100 is our desired BPM. For After Effects, you might find this expression useful. And that's all I wanted to cover in this video. The rest is up to your own creativity. Goodbye.